Hi, my name is Matthijs Hoekstra. I'm a program manager in the Microsoft Identity and Network Access organization, and I'm working on verifiable credentials and decentralized identifiers.
Hi, my name is Rohit Gulati. I'm a program manager as well in Microsoft Identity and Network Access Engineering. Like Matthijs, I also focus on Azure AD Verifiable Credential Service, and we both work with customers and partners in making them successful on this service. So let's talk about Azure AD Verifiable Credential Service Request API. And let me start by giving you a sneak preview of the agenda. So we'll do a quick overview of the Request API service. We'll explain the goals for it. We'll show you a demo of our .NET sample. And my colleague Matthijs will also show you a set of sequence diagrams so that you understand how the sample works, the issuer flow and the verifier flow. And at the end, we'll do a demo with Postman. So with that, let me start with the first topic. Let's talk about the Request API. So the Request Service REST API, why we build that? So that it is easy for developers to build applications. So you can use this Request API to build applications that can issue and verifiable credentials from any programming language that you are using. This new API will give you an abstraction layer, so you don't need to worry about the complexities of protocols and internal workings. Just go about onboarding the Azure AD Verifiable Credential Service, use your platform choice, bring in any programming language, and then you can get started. So let's start now with a quick demo of the .NET sample.
So I have my sample here in VisStudio. It's the .NET sample. We also published a Node, Java, and a Python sample. So let me quickly run it. And it consists of two sections, issuance and verification. So this one is running. Let me get to the browser. Because our service calls back to your web application, we typically advise people to use some kind of reverse proxy like ngrok, or you can publish it to an online service. I run a reverse proxy at home, so it connects to my own machine. So first, let's get the credential. I click on the button, and it should show a QR code, which I can scan with my authenticator wallet, which I have connected to a remote viewer here on the side. It updates the UI after I scan the QR code, asks me for a PIN and the card, add it to my wallet, and the UI is updated that credential was successfully issued. When I now go to the verification piece, click on the button, again, scan the QR code. I choose which credential I want to share. I allow sharing. And the result is printed on the screen. That's very quickly how the demo works. So high level, ASP.NET Core web app, which sends a request to our API to issue and verify a verifiable credential. The website will show a QR code pointing to a URL which is returned by the API. We have JavaScript in the web page, which pulls the web app to see if there's any change it needs to show in the UI. That's how we change. So when the QR code is scanned, we change the UI. And when issuance is completed or verification is completed, we change the UI. The web app meanwhile receives callbacks from our service. So when the wallet has reached the request through the QR code, we give you a callback. And when issuance or presentation is complete, our service gives your web app a callback as well. So the JavaScript is just a polling mechanism to make sure when the state changes, the UI changes as well. So maybe it's easier to just walk through the sequence diagram and explain in detail what happened. So we got the authenticator with the wallet. We got the browser with the HTML and the JavaScript. The web app is our .NET Core app running. And we got our credentialing of verifiable credential service running in the backend. So first I click on the Get Credential button in the browser, which calls a API from the web app, which in again calls our API with a specific payload. And Rohit will show the exact payload for the API. What we do return is an address where the issuance request, that's the thing we call the issuance request, is hosted. And authenticator needs to be able to download that request. So what we do is in our web app, we return that address to the browser. The browser creates with a JavaScript library a QR code. We can also send the QR code directly back from the API. Then authenticator scans the QR code, and inside of the QR code is the address of the complete request. Before it downloads that, it tries to resolve the DID from the issuer, resolve it against IAM, retrieves the document, retrieves the public key, and make sure all the messages coming from the service are signed correctly with the right private key. This is how a DID document looks like. The signature here in the middle, the public key of the public key used for signatures is here in the middle. This is what we can do after resolving a DID, making sure the public key is checked against the signature in the messages, and then we know it's actually coming from the right party. The checks out, we download the request. At that point, our service gives a call back to the web app, like, okay, somebody read the request. The browser pulls for status change and now knows, oh wait, somebody read the request, let's hide the QR code, but the request is already moved from the server by polling with a get status kind of a method. Authenticator downloads the credential. That's where we define how the card looks like, what claims you want to collect, etc. The user accepts the verifiable credential inside of the wallet. We post that info back to our service and make sure it's all signed. Again, a callback is sent to our web application. Since the browser is still polling to see if anything changed in the status. And if that's the case, after the verifiable credential is returned to the user, we can update the UI. That's very quickly how issuance done. How is verification done? Well, it's almost the same, right? Again, the same players in this scenario. I want to verify the credential. Click on the button in the browser. Our API, our web app calls the API with a specific payload. We return the address of the request, which we pass along back to the browser, and the browser creates a QR code. Same mechanism. Authenticator scans the QR code. There's a resolution of the DID from the relying party. And this is actually an important part because you want to make sure that the user is only sharing information with a trusted entity. So what we do, we look up in the document, the domain, and we go, the wallet goes to the domain to a .well-known/DID-configuration.json file, which you have to upload. Is signed with the same private key. So this proves that the relying party you are talking with is actually the owner of this domain. So this should give the user more assurance that the user is sharing information with a trusted entity. Authenticator downloads the request. We give a call back to the web app. The browser keeps polling for change with the get status API. The user selects the VC, presents it to our service. The callback hits our web app again, but now with the result of the validation of the verifiable credentials. So we do the validation and the verification of the signatures, etc. Browser still polling for any change. And if that arrived, it can now show the payload from the verifiable credential in our sample. And that's it. So Rohit can now show how the APIs work, what kind of payloads we have to send, and how authentication for that API works as well.
All right, I'm going to show a quick demo through Postman. Just to give you the experience of the API, how you can build an issuance payload and presentation payload. So to access the API, you need to get an access token. So you're following the client credentials flow. I'll get the access token. Let me use this token. And let me walk you through the issuance payload. So you can see the endpoint, the API endpoint. In the payload, there are certain parameters. So include QR code is a Boolean parameter. Then for authority, it's a string value. This is where you specify the decentralized identifier for the issuer. Then you have the registration section, which provides information about the issuer that can be displayed in the authenticator app. And then the issuance section that talks about the type of the credential, the manifest. This is something that you will create on the Azure AD Verifiable Credential Blade. And then you also have a callback section where, as a developer, you can use it to asynchronously get information on the flow. You saw in the sequence diagram. So during the whole VC issuance process, a developer might want a call when the issuer has or when the user has scanned a QR code. So if you want to get this kind of information, you will use this callback section. So and I'm using PIN in the payload, and you can see there are a bunch of claims that are mentioned. So let me just send the request. And we're using a small piece of code that looks for the QR code. And on the Postman, you can get the QR code in the Visualize tab. So I'm going to bring in my phone mirror as well on the screen. And let me also show you the whole experience through a phone mirroring experience. So I have my phone mirroring on. Let me open the authenticator app and let me scan this QR code. So as I scan the QR code, you saw the flow that the authenticator app will look at the request. It is asking me to specify the PIN for this payload. The PIN was 1234. Can see it's a verified domain, and I'll click on add to accept this credential. And when I double click on it under the credential info, I can see the claim values, first name and last name.
Can you also show the results from the call again instead of the visualizer? Then you can actually see that return or that address of the request. So the URL. That's the piece which is actually encoded in that QR code for authenticator to download. And if you would be on mobile, it would be directly to that URL. So the QR code is useful for testing like this, but in the end, it's about that address which is specified there as open ID, semicolon, WAC, VC. That's the, and then the next, that's where the address lives, and authenticator will download the request from that address.
Great. Let me now show the presentation payload, and let's just quickly go through that payload parameter list. What I explained during issuance flow, the include QR code is a Boolean value. Authority is a string value where you specify the decentralized identifier of your verifier. And if you look at the registration section, you will specify information about your verifier. Presentation will have details like what is the requested credential type, the purpose, and we have a value called accepted issuer. This is an array field. So what I'm saying that I can accept a credential of type verifiable credential expert from the issuer that has this DID identifier. And it's an array, so you can build your logic around that. And as I explained in the issuance payload, there is a callback section as well. So as a developer, you can use it to update the UI during the verifiable credential presentation process. So I'll send this request. And here too, I'll go to the visualize button and I will scan the QR code. So you can see the the request was for verifiable credential expert credential type. I'll hit on allow. And the request was approved.
So where it accepted issue as an array, so you can accept the same kind of credential from different issuers, but it looks like that requested credentials is also an array. Does it mean I can ask for more than one credential?
Yes, you can. Let me just show you that too. So I have another post request to show. And just to expand on the payload for this post request, calling out for what Matthias was asking as a question. So I have a request where I want the user to tell me that user has the verifiable credential expert credential type and also has a true identity credential. So who you are can be verified, and you are also a expert that can be verified. So in this request, you can see there is a payload with type verifiable credential expert coming from this accepted issuer that I can take, and a true identity type where I will use it to prove my true identity for you from an issuer that is coming from this accepted issuer list. So let me send this request. And let me go to the visualize tab. If I scan this QR code, you will see that. So the request was for two credentials and I have both the credentials in my wallet. I will hit on allow. And you can see the request was approved. So that was a quick demonstration of the whole flow using Postman. There are details available on our public website with respect to issuing API specification and presentation API specification. So short links for resources, you can look at the sample using aka.ms/vcsample. We have a developer documentation set, and we also have step-by-step documentation with akms./vcsetup. We hope this was useful. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next video.